the dignities of the dais, faculty members, staff, and of course the dear students. When I came in the morning, I received the sad news of the demise of Dr. Pathanvara Kadam. I would like to start my short speech to say that it is soul, rest in peace. I have also seen those students who came here very proudly, smile on their face. I must congratulate them, and I hope that next time you will have more students in the list, in the merit list of the university. I understand also that many of you are the first batch of the affiliating colleges which has decided to join the university last year. As one of the colleges, we have now almost 100 colleges with us and more than 12,000 students. When we started this university as an affiliating university, and we took the first step of deciding what needs to be taught to the budding engineers, and we thought that we'll have to be different. We have to be different from the conventional universities where the teaching is still conventional. And as an engineering professional, I strongly believe that merely passing examination does not make you a good engineer. You definitely have a degree in your hand. The degree will probably open up the doors or opportunities for you. But eventually, we will have to show that what you can do with your education. You have now a plethora of engineering institutions throughout the country, including Maharashtra. And the number of engineering graduates come out of it. And you would be one of them in just 4 years down the line. Some of you could be graduating this year, some next year, another next following years. But recall that throughout the country, the number of engineering which are produced are in excess of 10 lakhs. In Maharashtra alone, we produce almost 1 lakh engineers every year. And if you want to get noticed in that crowd, and if you suppose go out for your jobs, you would be in amongst many of such graduates. And it would be your responsibility to show that you are different from others. So you can now start asking a question to yourself. How are you different? What differentiates you from the remaining students? Because otherwise, they go through the similar syllabus, if not the same. They appear for the similar examinations. They answer the same questions. They also get the similar GPA, later on it becomes a GPA. You will have 9 pointers, here are 10 pointers, and you will have to compete with them. The competition is severe, particularly in engineering profession today. So we have a large number of students and less number of opportunities. How will you then compete with your friends, maybe your best friend who is sitting right next to you, with whom you share your class notes and assignments and copy them as well? Now time has come where you decide what you want to be. It's a professional course. It is not like just any degree course. So when you graduate, we expect you to be really a professional engineer. The only way you can show that you are capable of doing something that with your own hands. I strongly believe engineers cannot be produced simply by writing answers sitting in front of the computers. You have to learn to make your hands dirty. And that you have to do right from the day one. If you have been taken through the induction program, which was specified by the university, I hope you have gone through at least one of those exercises. We have, when we look at our own engineering, our education system per se, up to probably 7th standard and maybe up to 8th standard, you have retained your curiosity. You enter 9th standard and all your curiosity vanishes. The only thing that you do is the standard questions, expected questions and their answers. Apekshit prashna and atensha uttar. This is not what education means. Education means you try to understand what is not known to you at least. And unfortunately, this is taught in Indian society right from the home. For example, when you were a kid, a toddler, if you break the first toy which is given to you, you get the first lesson saying that you have broken it, you are not going to get the second one. You might even get a slap for breaking something. And that is conditioning you right from the home. You get so much condition that you are afraid of breaking anything, of opening anything. And you tend to avoid doing the things with your hands. Now is the time when you regain your curiosity. You are now already in the engineering profession. If you want to be an engineer, you must build something on your own. When we discuss about innovation, innovation means invention and innovation, they are two different things. Just to give a simple example, Michael Faraday and the Davy, Sir Humphrey Davy, are the two names which are associated with electricity. So those were inventions. But they did not make the money. Money was made by Edison, who converted and made the electricity available to households the way it is available today. And because there was also a fight between Edison and Tesla for the direct current and the alternating current. But the money is made by the people who make use of the information. And I'm sure my industry friends will agree with it. Knowledge is generated in the colleges, but the industry makes the money. Now it is the time has come for us to understand how industry functions. As an engineer, you need to understand this. If you are right now in the final year, it is time you go out in the industry and see how industry functions. And I would even recommend the teachers should go to industry and see how the industry functions. Because an industry sometimes can be well ahead of what you have been teaching in the class. Mr. Corbe said, the things have changed since he became engineer. Usually, even I remember, when I started my engineering profession just like you, we had no computer. We had no calculator. We used the calculations with the log tables and the slide rule. Today, what was then the dream has become the reality. And the phone which you carry in your pocket is one of the most powerful computer available to you. But you will not use it for a computer, right? Because you are afraid of jailbreaking it. You are afraid saying that if I make some change in the operating system, it will not function. Even the phone is, if it is old, working still, most of the phones are very sturdy. This will work. But you will not change it. You probably will give it back to the vendor and get a 500 or 1000 rupees as a discount for the new phone. A time has come when you can think against that, saying that, can I use that phone, modified operating system, and use it for the mobile computing? Innovations happen when you think differently. Innovations can happen only when you see what opportunities are lying around you. And you must do that as a part, as an individual or as a group. Ask your teachers if required. And we have asked all engineering colleges to start clubs. Clubs, not only for your dance and music and so on. Clubs to learn your profession. Clubs where you can invite the industry people who can interact with you, or who can provide a mentorship to you, who can provide an internship to you. And this is very important part of the engineering profession. We have a compulsory industrial internship after third year. Yes, it is in fact said you must undergo 3 internships of 1 month each it will become mandatory for all of those in the first year. This will become mandatory to undergo 3 1-month internships throughout the course of 4 years. That also means we need to work with the industry. And to the industry, you look at this group of the students as the future engineers, future technologists, and the group of our population which is now in the higher strata of the society, who are capable of doing many things, provided they get an opportunity. So if you have an issue, if you have a problem, or if you have the problem that you do not have enough manpower to work on, offer them the opportunity to work on it. Let them come back to you with certain solutions. I'm not saying that they will come up with the best solution, but they will definitely come up with certain solutions. Your mind is still right and it is not yet corrupted. Corrupted in the sense when otherwise once you go to the industry, you always think everything in terms of the money. Of course, this is important. You need to have money. But when we work as a professional, we work for optimum solution. The best need not be all the time optimum. Optimum solution with respect to of the technological feasibility as well as economical feasibility. You need to understand where your world is going. 3 years ago, we were talking about 2G. It was just age before. Last year it was 3G, this year it is 4G. And we are already at the threshold of the 5G, where the machine-to-machine communication becomes now very important. Our speed of communication is becoming faster and faster and faster. You look at everything that your mobile phone is able to do. You find apps which can keep a control or rather the monitoring of your parameters like heartbeats, the pressure, pulses, everything. That is how the thing is going to be changed. Now we talk on reset train and talking about what should happen in the 5 years down the line. Tomorrow everything that you do will be connected to the computers and the cloud. Your cloud probably can send a message on your mobile saying that today you have not taken walk. Today you have not done your exercise. It's already telling you that how many steps you are walking. Industrial automation is becoming a part of the life. It is going to stay there. So don't expect that you will go tomorrow in the industry and everything is done manually. Automation is a part of the life now. It means I need to learn something different which I did not learn myself 10 years ago. So you have to learn every day. The technology changes every day. So take this as a challenge. It's a challenge, but if you accept the challenge, you would have a lot of opportunities. But if you stick only to your class notes, I'm sorry, we cannot guarantee anything after your graduation. But if you learn something, build something different, plenty of people will be waiting outside for you to come out. So take this more as a message from me. I'll be here in the afternoon as well to have another meeting. But a message to all of you is, please don't sit in a classroom. Get out of the classroom. Go into the field. Find out what opportunities are lying there for you. Take those projects for you to solve in the next 4 years. Come up with solutions that you can offer to the industry, to the society. And that is the way you can build yourself, not only as a great professional, but also as a very good human being. Thank you very much.